Hi, I'm Trev Hutchings, and this is how to create a tape rewind effect in BandLab. So here I have a vocal track I recorded earlier, and I'm going to use this vocal recording to create a tape rewind effect.
Now let me tell you, let's go back and start again.
You can use any audio recording you like, so vocals, guitars, music, etc. First, tap on the plus icon. Tap on voice audio. Then tap on the X icon. Next, tap on the vocal recording. And tap on the copy icon. Now scroll the screen so the track position marker line is where you want the tape rewind effect to start. Tap on the new audio track and tap on the pop-up paste icon. Now tap on the copy of the recording. Tap on the three dots. Then tap on reverse. So now the recording plays backwards. Next, tap on the recording again. Tap on the three dots. And tap on time stretch. We want to speed up the recording for a rewind effect. So tap on the time stretch speed. And tap on 2.00. Then tap on the tick icon. Now, we need to add a pitch change effect. So tap on the track header. Tap on effects. Tap on the plus icon. Scroll through the tabs. And tap on the pitch shift tab. Then tap on pitch shifter. One pitch shifter won't get the pitch high enough, so tap on the plus icon and tap on pitch shifter again. The tape mechanism creates a warble, so let's add that effect. Tap on the plus icon, scroll through the tabs, and tap on the modulation tab. Then tap on Auto Wah. Next, tap on the filter mode drop list. And tap on HPF. Then tap on positive. Then tap on the release text box. Type in 60. And tap on save. Then tap on the speed text box, type in 35, and tap on save. Now tap on the back arrow, then tap on the X icon. Next, we need to automate the pitch change. So tap on the automation icon. Tap on the automation drop list. Tap on the first pitch shifter. And tap on shift. Now tap on the automation line three times to add three dots. Tap on the first dot and drag it left, so it is at the start of the audio recording. And drag it up or down, so the pop-up message says 0ST. Tap on the third dot and drag it up and right, so it is at the end of the audio recording, and the pop-up message says 12ST. Then tap on the second dot and drag it up and to the middle of the recording, so the pop-up message says 12ST. Now tap on the automation drop list and tap on the second pitch shifter. Then tap on Shift. Tap on the automation line three times to add three dots. Tap on the first dot and drag it left, so it is at the start of the audio recording, and drag it up or down, so the pop-up message says 0ST. Tap on the third dot and drag it up and right, so it is at the end of the audio recording, and the pop-up message says 12ST. And tap on the second dot and drag it up and to the middle of the recording, so the pop-up message says 12ST. Then tap on the automation icon to hide automation. Finally, we want to add a tape click sound. So tap below the recording. Then tap on the pop-up samples icon. Then tap on Samples. Tap on the Search icon. Then type in LIL, Rich, Space, Click, and tap on the Search icon. Then tap on the plus icon next to Lil Rich, Click Perk. Now press on the sample and drag it to the start of the recording. Then tap on the sample and tap on the copy icon. Then drag the screen so the track position marker line is at the end of the recording. Tap on the sample track and tap on the pop-up paste icon. Now tap on the mixer settings icon and drag the dot on the sample track volume slider left to reduce the volume of the click. For my recording, I set the sample track volume level to about minus 20 dB. Then tap on the mixer settings icon again.
Now let me tell you, oh hang on, let's go back and start again.
If you enjoyed this video, do give us a thumbs up and click on that subscribe button. Cheers!